Hello, everyone. Today, I wanted to talk to you about the Federal Reserve Bank and how they're planning on cutting interest rates this month. And they have announced that they are ready to do that, especially after the latest employment report showing that the employment is softening. So the question is, how much are they going to cut rates and how soon? Okay, so they're saying that they're ready to cut interest rates. The U.S. Central Bank poised to cut rates by September 17-18 meeting, and the policymakers are focused on cooling labor markets. Traders expect Fed's first move to be 25 basis points cut. There was some talk about lowering 50 basis point, but even though the market, the economy is in poor shape right now, a cut of 50 basis point might imply that they are in panic mode. So I'm sure they probably want to avoid that and just make it look like, okay, we're just going to start with 25 basis point. The Federal Reserve policymakers on Friday signaled they are ready to kick off a series of interest rates cuts at the U.S. Central Bank's meeting in 2 weeks, noting a cooling in the labor market that could accelerate into something more dire in the absence of a policy shift. Their remarks were widely seen as endorsing a quarter percentage point reduction in the Fed's policy rate and leaving the door open to further and perhaps bigger moves should the job market continue to slow down. So they also said that policymakers have kept the Fed's benchmark borrowing rate at a 5.25% to 5.5% range since July of 2023, and after an aggressive rate hike campaign that began 18 months earlier in response to a surge in inflation. Inflation by the Fed's preferred measure is now well down from the mid-2022 peak at around 7%, the unemployment rate at 3.5% when the Fed stopped rising rates, and now they're recent to 4.2% monthly job growth has slowed. U.S. central bankers have turned the monetary policy page, completing their shift to a focus on supporting jobs from what had been a singular focus bringing down inflation. It is now appropriate to dial down the degree of restrictiveness in the stance of policy by reducing the target for the federal funds, end quote, by the New York Fed President John Williams, said at the Council on Foreign Relations event. Speaking at the University of Notre Dame, Fed Governor Christopher Walter went further, saying he could support back-to-back cuts on bigger cuts if the data suggests the need. So hiring continues to slow down. So we're having major problems and crisis from all levels and from all corners. And we're seeing, we had first quantitative easing taking place, which is the Fed was printing money excessively for many, many years, which made the interest rates basically zero effectively. And now we're seeing the consequences. Inflation has gone up, and is the inflation that they tell us doesn't really account for a lot of other things. And now hiring continues to slow down, and unemployment is on the rise, and we are headed into a recession now. So now what they want to do is to stimulate the economy, is to do what they always do, which is to reduce interest rates again. And in the short term, it might seem really plausible, especially for people wanting to buy homes and people wanting to sell their homes, but it's going just to make inflation worse. And there is really uncertainty of what's going to happen to the employment, to the job market. So we need to keep our eyes on it and just keep in mind the fact that as interest rates go down, there is more supply of the money supply increases, which means that the dollar is going to depreciate even further. And that's going to mean also that real assets are going to be the way to go, including real estate. Even though it's going to be cheaper right now, again, to be able to purchase real estate, we need to keep in mind that holding physical assets is the best option instead of having a dollar that is devaluating. So that's all I have to do, all I have for you today. Please subscribe to my video, my channel, and I hope to have you back again. Thank you. Are you tired of the city life? In recent years, in the wake of some global events, many Americans have found themselves wanting to relocate in search for a new frontier away from the city life, the homelessness, crowded areas, high crime, and chaos. For many, they wish to capitalize on the freedom that remote work provides. For some, finding affordable housing, looking for rural locations to save money. The move toward rural America is still going. The National Association of Realtors still support this trend. The reason? People are looking for better quality of life, housing affordability, safety, more space, less pollution, connecting with nature, and more freedom. In this channel, we analyze real estate market trends and examine all the different areas throughout the U.S. where opportunities are for those who are looking to get out of the cities and start a new life for them and their families. If you're looking to relocate anywhere in the U.S., please contact me to schedule a Zoom consultation. I have been a real estate broker for almost 2 decades with experience in relocation strategies and would be happy to assist you in your particular situation.